What is up? This is Flutter Mentor, and I'm going to explain to you what exactly the build context really is. And I'm going to explain it in very basic and simple terms so that even complete beginners can understand it. If you already know Flutter well and you just need to see an example, then feel free to skip ahead to the chapter of the video that is called Using Build Context. So as you can see, the UI is incredibly simple. It's literally just a scaffold, and then there's only one widget in the body, which is the elevated button. That's why it doesn't look so good, but I made this way just so there would be nothing confusing you. But anyway, it's an elevated button, and when you click it, it's supposed to make a snack bar show up right here, and that's it. I'm gonna leave the URL to this documentation on the description of the video, but I think that most people who read this don't really understand it in the end. That's why I'm creating this video. But honestly, the first sentence pretty much tells you everything you need to know, because what is the build context? It's actually much more simple than you would think. Like it says right here, it's a handle to the location of a widget in the widget tree. That means that the build context is basically how your widget gets information about itself, mainly where it's located on the widget tree. This sentence is also pretty good. It's saying that pretty much some functions like showDialog or theme.of, for example, take the build context so that they can act on behalf of the calling widget or obtain data specifically for the given context. Basically, just imagine that all the widgets that need context or people who got wasted, they just got really drunk last night and then they woke up and they just have no idea where they are or what they're supposed to be doing. And so the context is what tells them everything they need to know in order for them to do their function correctly, whatever that may be. Generally speaking, there are two use cases for a build context. Either the widget interacts with its parents to get or send data, or, and this happens less often, once rendered on the screen, the widget wants to get the screen size and position, but it's mostly to interact with its parents and to know where on the widget tree it belongs. So basically, context is pretty much just an argument that you give to a method that needs the information that the context holds in order to perform its function. If that's too complicated, let me show you this widget map right here. And basically what they're saying is, for example, let's imagine the container is a widget that requires a context. Well, what the container would need to know is where in the widget tree he is. In this case, he is underneath the column that is underneath the row that is underneath the container. And then the container takes that information and paints itself on the screen. For example, imagine it would go right here. And now that the container knows where it's located within the widget tree, it can do its job much better. Now the container doesn't actually need a context, but imagine it did. However, the context does not give it any information about horizontal widgets in the widget tree. That means this container would know nothing about this container or this icon, etc. But coming back to the build context class, if you scroll down a little bit, you will see that they are also using a snack bar as an example. And the way you use a snack bar is you call the scaffold.of method, and that method needs a context in order to show the snack bar. And the confusing thing here is that it says right here, scaffold.of context returns null. And then here it says scaffold.of context returns the locally created scaffold. Now, what the hell does that mean? Well, there should be an arrow right here into the builder, because here you're talking about this context and here you're talking about this context. But let me simplify this on Android Studio. Here we have a similar example as the one I just showed you, but there's no builder method at all. And in this case, it should work, right? Because the scaffold is right here, and the very first widget that the scaffold has on its body property, which if you press Ctrl Q, tells you that this is the primary content of the scaffold, then this should work, right? It should totally work, because you're asking for the context right within the first level of the scaffold. So why wouldn't it work, right? Let's try it out. If I click it, nothing happened. And if I open this, we see an error. And by the way, notice that I named this class first widget from widget tree, just so it wouldn't be confusing for you. And also notice how it says the context used was first widget from widget tree. They are literally telling you that the context used was the class's context. And that's not the context that they want. They want the context below the scaffold, aka the context that the build method returns, not the context that the build method carries from the class. And if we scroll up, here is the error right here. The first thing you read is scaffold.of called with a context that does not contain a scaffold. Now this can seem like a very confusing error message right here, because technically this is a scaffold, and then right within the first widget you're asking for a context that contains a scaffold, right? At least that's what you think you're doing, but apparently not. And then if you keep reading, it says right here, no scaffold ancestor could be found starting from the context that was passed to scaffold.of. And now this is the key part right here. This usually happens when the context provided is from the same stateful widget or stateless widget as that whose build function actually creates the scaffold widget. Now, what the hell does that mean again? Well, they're saying that what you're doing wrong is asking for the context from the same stateful or stateless, in this case, widget, as the build function that creates the scaffold widget. And this is when it gets tricky, because this context should not be this context at all. And this is why most people always get an error when they try to use a snack bar. Now, in order to help you to understand this, I'm going to change the name of this context to first widget from widget tree's context, which means this is the context from this class right here. It's really important that you understand that the context that the build method passes over is the context from this class. And depending on your programming experience, I don't know if you've noticed, but this right here is just a method. This is the type that the method returns, this is the name of the method, this is the argument of the method, and then within the curly braces is the method. And as you can see, it returns a scaffold, which is a widget. And then here are just the properties of the widget. I could delete this, and as you can see, this is just a method that returns a scaffold. And now if we go back here, they give you a few solutions to fix the problem. They tell you to either use a builder to get a context that is under the scaffold, or you could split the build function into several widgets, because this will introduce a new context from which you can obtain the scaffold. Now let's try the first builder option. Let's wrap this widget right here with another widget called builder, and instead of child, it's going to be builder, and then it's going to have its own context, and it returns elevated button. And just a side note, the arrow is exactly the same as having these two curly braces and then using the word return. It's exactly the same. And now this context right here refers to this one, but I'm actually going to rename it to make sure there's no confusion. I'm going to call this context returned by the build method, and that's what I want you to understand. So there are two different build contexts at play right now. And now that the snack bar is using the write context, which is the builder's context, and once again, if you look at the error message, it says right here, use a builder to get a context that is under the scaffold, because this context right here is above the scaffold. So they want the one that's under the scaffold. And that's pretty much what the builder method is doing right now. So if I restart the app now and I click it, it will say scaffold ancestor found within this context. So the snack bar worked. Now the other solution to this would be to remove the builder and we just have the elevated button right here. But I'm actually going to delete it because I have a class right here that is the exact same code, elevated button text. Only thing that's changed is this right here. Let me change it. And now we just gotta do button. And I need you to notice that this widget right here, the one that I just created, also has a build method that is being overridden. And so it has its own context underneath the scaffold. And I need you to understand that this is essentially a class called button. And we extend the stateless widget, which has the build method, and we override that build method. And if I restart the app right now and I click it, it's going to work again. Right there. The scaffold ancestor was found within this context. So I hope you understand the build context now that you know what's going on behind the scenes. If this video helps you in any way, please leave me a like. And only subscribe if you want to keep on learning Flutter. That's pretty much it. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.